Abhishek Manu Singhvi, the senior lawyer representing the Maharashtra government, joins me now, sir. You know, we just had the Bihar Director General of Police. He says that as far as jurisdiction is concerned, this was very much under his purview because it's not an ordinary case. How would you respond to that?
Okay, Vishnu, you are not a lawyer. The vast number of your viewers are not lawyers. I want to ask you a commonsensical question. A murders B in Mumbai, commits suicide in Mumbai, criminally intimidates in Mumbai, slaps in Mumbai, thieves in Mumbai, defalcates in Mumbai. Every conceivable element of this act allegedly happens in Mumbai. In nobody's case, it happens outside. Can Bihar file an FIR because the family or the father of the victim or the deceased lives in Bihar? Second ground given by Bihar, and you have to read that to believe, it's amazing, it's unbelievable. Bihar's second ground given is that the consequences of this are felt all over India. Third is that the erstwhile employees of the deceased, Sushant, live all over India and they are witnesses. Fourth ground is the high sensitivity of the case. If you accept this, Vishnu, you are turning criminal law on its head. That old Sanskrit saying, dharmo rakshate dharma. The law protects those who protect themselves and who protect the law. The law protects those who protect the law. Will mean that by consent, the accused and the victim decide to choose right. their place.
But sir, let me ask you this.
Maharashtra police.
Sir, let me ask you this. The Bihar policeman was not allowed.
The accused and the victim decide to file a case in Kerala. Or because the event occurs in Kerala and the effect is felt by a sister in Jammu and Kashmir,
right.
you will have the prosecution by J&K. You will have simultaneous prosecution.
Okay,
that's
but sir, let
one.
Me ask you this.
Point two is a much larger constitutional point, which I argued specifically today. Because I'm only appearing because the case is over. I don't appear in any matter where I'm a counsel while the case is on. And I'm appearing only to summarize the contentions I made before the learned judge today.
Right.
The second is federalism. You know, suppose a state X and you are the chief minister of state Y is of political color X and the center is of political color Y and X and Y are inimical. I'm giving an example only. State X is opposed in political color to state Y.
Okay, so one second, sir, let me just jump in over here because I must ask you this. Sir, the Bihar policeman was not allowed to investigate. He was locked up because of COVID. How is this fair?
Let me tell you, Vishnu, first of all, if a policeman is locked up in COVID by the BMC and there is an error in it, how does it affect and change the jurisdiction? Does it go Bihar jurisdiction? I mean, absolutely two different things are being combined. If a policeman is wrongly locked up by BMC on a non-quarantine issue, it gives jurisdiction to Bihar.
Okay.
Let me tell you the second point. There are enough people in every investigation dissatisfied. In Delhi, in Mumbai, in Bihar, in Kerala.
Right.
The procedure is to complain to the magistrate of that state. And then the magistrate, no, then to the High Court. Does it mean that if you are dissatisfied with Mumbai police, you will file a FIR in Kerala? I've never heard of this. And the third thing is federalism. If you had this, then you could have an invasion of every state power. Remember, law and order comes in the exclusive state competence. Which is why even in the act which creates the CBI, there is a section 6 which says CBI can come into and take over a law and order case from a state only with the consent of the state. Why is that principle? That's the federal principle.
So, therefore, sir, I have one final question to ask you. In your opinion, what is the larger political play over here? Is it related to this case or are we looking at something else?
I have said in the court today, Vishnu, I have said in the court today, that I can lay a bet that come Bihar election and they are over, nobody will even remember this case. Mr. Sushant Singh will be forgotten as a son of Bihar. All these allegations of the family is all about Bihar elections. It's very unfortunate that it's been made into a political issue. I mean, everybody respects the sentiment of the family, but just because the family lives, part of it lives in Bihar, how can Bihar get jurisdiction? It has been made into a Bihari versus pride versus Mumbai pride. I don't understand this. And it is pure politics because unfortunately, and I lay this charge squarely at the central government door, The central government, to put it bluntly, may like the political color in Bihar, it may not like the political color in Maharashtra. That has nothing to do with criminal law.
Okay.
I said today that in the fullness of time, people will decide whether there is a murder, suicide or whatever. But certainly today we are murdering the CRPC.
All right. Well, you heard both sides. You heard both sides of this debate, what the Bihar government, the Director General of Police had to say, and also what Dr. Singhvi had to say over there. We haven't shouted or screamed at all in this debate, which is the way the Sushant Singh Rajput case is being reported. But as you can see, strong issues of ethics, political ethics, propriety, and the law. Will there be justice for Sushant Singh Rajput? That's the question, perhaps, to which there are no answers. We'll take a short break. More coming up.